Welcome back. In this video, we are going to see another scenario for data cleanup. I strongly recommend that you have a look at the clean data checklist video first. That will give you better understanding of the concepts involved. Here we have data which violates rule 6 and 8. Rule 6 says one column should contain one meaning. But here you can see one column contains two meanings at least. Assets, which is main category, and subcategory. To make matters worse, we also have the data interrupted with subtotals and grand total. This is an output format. This is not an input format. Ideally, the input format should be three columns. In this case, category, subcategory, and amount. From that input data, we can create an output like this using pivot table or any other tool. This data is similar. The difference is the category and subcategory is at least in two different columns. Both these tables have been given a name. This table has a name problem 68. This table has a name problem 8. Using Power BI and Power Query, let us see how to clean up this data. We will start with this table, and while we are cleaning this table, at some point we will reach the structure of this table. So you'll learn solution to both problems in a single process. I'm going to go to Power BI and import this Excel file. We are going to choose the table problem 68. The data needs to be cleaned up, so we are going to click on the transform data button. This opens Power Query. Now we are using Power BI to do this import and cleanup. But remember, Power Query is available in Excel as well. If you have Excel 2016 or above, you will see data, get and transform. That is same as Power Query. If you have older version of Excel, you can install an add-in called Power Query, which gives you a separate menu, but features are similar. So whatever I am showing in Power BI is directly applicable to Excel. The data is inside Power Query, so now let's clean it. Before we do that, just understand all the steps we take to clean up data get added here as applied steps. If you don't see this section, go to View tab and activate Query Settings. One more thing you have to enable. Every step which is applied converts to a formula. It's like recording a macro. The formula is shown here in the formula bar. If you can't see the formula bar, enable it from View Formula Bar. Now let's clean up the data. First thing we need to do is get rid of the totals. Right click inside one of the rows containing the word total. And we want to filter out the rows which contain the word total. We want to keep the rows where the word total is not there. So we say does not contain. Now, unfortunately, what happens? It only removes that row. Total liabilities, total spices are not affected. Don't worry, look at the formula. Because we right clicked on that particular row, it has literally taken that phrase. All that we have to do is remove the word assets. Press enter and the job is done. The next step is to split the item column into two separate columns, category and subcategory. Remember, wherever there is a category, it is starting in the beginning. Wherever there is subcategory, it is starting with spaces. In this case, there are three spaces. In your case, it may be whatever number of spaces. You figure it out. How do you do that? You add a special column called conditional column. We are creating a new column, so we have to give it a name. We will call this column category. The next step is to give the condition. if the item column does not begin with a space, then it's a category. Like I said, liability, spices, social. So output, what do we want? The item itself. So we choose column item. Now, if this is not true, that means it does begin with a space like land, building, then we don't want anything there. Don't want anything is called null. If you don't specify anything, it'll anyway put null. Let's create another conditional column for subcategory. If item begins with, in this case, three spaces. I could have put one space also, but remember, this is a simple example. In real life, you could have two levels, one with three spaces, another one six spaces. That's why it is better to be precise here. In that case, I again want the item to be shown. And if it is not found, then null. Compare this with our problem 8 table. That is exactly the stage at which problem 8 table is. So if your data is in two separate columns, like the problem 8 table, then you start from here and proceed further. Now we want to get rid of these and actually fill assets, liabilities here. So each row contains complete information. You already know how to do that. Right click on category column and say fill down. That's done. Might as well change the data type to text. 1 to 3 ABC means any. You have to explicitly call it text. Now, this one, we don't want to fill the nulls, because if you fill it with something, it's irrelevant because there is no amount there. In fact, we want to get rid of the rows which contain null in subcategory. So now I'm right clicking inside the row containing null and saying only keep the rows which do not equal to null. Now it's done. Change the data type to text. Now we don't need this item column any longer. Say remove. And now we have clean data. So that is how you clean up hierarchical data and get rid of unwanted totals. Subscribe to the channel, because I'm going to create more such videos which are very useful and they're going to save you a lot of time. So that's all for now. See you soon. Thank you.